Gates of Discord. Yeah, for a bunch of, so many things happened during that production cycle. One being, we had this vision for what this world would look like. And we had some zones made, and it was supposed to feel like a really organic space, like the ground was meant in one area to feel like a bit flesh, and the trees would almost be like veins and stuff. And we got it, and it was like a steak exploded. It was really strange. And so we were looking at it going, we can't rescue this. We've got to throw everything out and start over. And we did. And I basically succeeded in making everything unnameable. And as a designer, probably the design team would say I got involved too early. but it's amazing how looking back, and we still do take things very seriously. But you know, and sometimes it does a really good job to define for the team how your content can be cohesive. So you establish, you know, what are the racial norms for a new race you add into the game? What are some of their habits and traits? Sometimes you can define how do they speak? What is their language akin to in English or some other language in the world? And quite often, you know, academically it seems amazing. And then on occasion, it's not so awesome. So sometimes when you let that get away from you, it can sometimes not be super great. So Gates of Discord, I worked with the team on building sort of a very, for one of the races, we called them Muramites, and it was a very consonant heavy language and how these characters were named. And so we'd have characters that had like five or six consonants in a row and things you absolutely can't pronounce, and that's when you, and that's, it's on me. I've been apologizing for it since 2004, I think. But this is one of those things where if you kind of let it get away from you and the spirit is lost, that you can end up with those kinds of things, and you start recognizing how important it is that your game and the main characters be pronounceable. We have a lot of examples where that's not necessarily been the case, and it loses something, especially when players are constantly sharing who they need to fight, who they need to kill. When you can pronounce them, it's helpful. It didn't go well, but everything else did, and it's funny how when we launched then, we also had implemented DirectX 9 and basically broke everything and launched too soon, and we were doing 6-month expansions at that time, which we discovered very quickly that's too fast for the team, especially with testing. And if we're upgrading tech, which we did then and we continue to do, we test it more now. So that one, I think, was the most complicated because we were trying to adjust to a new design philosophy, new zones, everything was coming in hot, and we had all this new tech, and we didn't have time to vet everything. But now people look back at it and go, that was the best expansion that ever happened. And where were you?